এরকম করে দেয় সব, তুমি একজন পণ্ডিত। মহাপুরুষ নিয়েছে
অতিমাত্রচরিত্রায় স্বাসিতানন্দায় জীবনায় নাম বঞ্ছাকল্পতরুভ্যশ্চ কৃপাসিন্ধুভ্যৈব চ পতিতানাম পাবনেভ্যো নমো মহাপতন্নায় কৃষ্ণপ্রেমপ্রদায় কৃষ্ণায় কৃষ্ণচৈতন্যনাম গৌরবিশে গুরবে গৌরচন্দ্রায় রাধিকায় কৃষ্ণায় কৃষ্ণভক্তায় Now, today is very sacred day. Chaturmasya Vrat is going on, and in Chaturmasya, Kartik Vrat is going on. It has been begun from Ekadashi, Dwadashi. Today is Dwadashi. And again it will be commenced on full moon Sarada Purnima, from Sarada Purnima to Purnima. It has been written in Hari Bhakti Vilas that from Kartik Mas, Damodar Vrat, Urja Vrat should begin from either from Ekadashi, either from Padashi, either from full moon Sarada Purnima. But the Gaudiya Vaishnava, especially Saraswata Gaudiya Vaishnava, in the line of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, they are called Saraswata Gaudiya Vaishnava. So Prabhupada has followed it from full moon to full moon, Sarada Purnima to Arash Purnima. Because Saraswati Thakur has established new thing, not new, same thing, but in a new way. If Saraswati Thakur and Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not in this planet, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings would have gone and stopped. So we should try to follow Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur in all rest. Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swami, and Sukh Sanyasi here in the midst of this
He had
Paul. He also followed Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, and our Reverend Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, because he gave sannyas to him. So he has followed all these things. So we should try to follow it from Purnima to Purnima. Those who are following from Ekadashi or Dwadashi, they also should samapta karma ke end that this Prat Kartik Damodar Purja Prat on full moon. So in this month, today is a very sacred day, Dwadashi. The separation,
disappearance day
of Raghunath Das Goswami,
Gopal
Bhatt Goswami, and Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, three pillars of Gaudiya Vaishnava among so many. So first we should take Gopal Bhatt Goswami. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went in Chaturmasya Vrata in the South India, Ranganji temple. And he began to dance and do kirtan there. All were attracted. And a very holy family met him. And they called Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that you should live for months here in our
residence.
And after you can go anywhere. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted their invitation. And he went to their residence. They have separate room for him on the bank of Tapti River. Tapti or Kaveri, I don't remember. And he spent 4 months there. The name of the head of the family was father of Gopal Bhatt Goswami, named Primalla Bhatt. Primalla Bhatt, his brother,
Venkat
Bhatt, Primalla Bhatt, and Prabodhananda Saraswati, the three brothers. They have taken initiation in the line of Srila Ramanuja, Sri Sampradaya. And they were very learned person from all South India. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu began to do kirtan and to tell so many things, Harikatha, to them. In 1 month, they were all changed totally. They were the first day, they were worshipper of Lakhi and Narayan, but by the association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they became Gaudiya Vaishnava, worshipper of Radha and Krishna, conjugal. This boy, Raghunath Das Gopal Bhatt Goswami, serving Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in so many ways. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to go to take bath in that river, sacred river, he used to go with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with his cloths, a door and coffin, and when he used to take his bath and coming to the residence, he used to take the water mixed cock cloths, cooking, and so many ways. so many things.
He used to suck day
and night, and he came so much pleased to him.
The history is so long, how they became
Gaudiya Vaishnava,
worshipper of Radha and Krishna. But anyhow, Gopal Bhatt served Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so well, and he was so learned person, because Prabodhananda Saraswati was a very big learned person at that time. He knows Ved, Upanishad, Vedanta Sutra, and Srimad Bhagavata especially. He has written so many books, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made him so rashi Vaishnava. That is why he has written after that Radha Rashudhanisi, a book, very, very jewel book. There are two books Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discovered.
Krishna
Karnamrit, one book, and second?
Brahma
Samhita. The third book, this book was so prominent, and all the Chaitanya Acharya has taken his slopes. Krishna Karnamrit is somewhat inclined towards Krishna and showing that Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. But Radha Sudhanidhi is more rashi book, and he is going to pray Radhika as a master of Srimad, of Krishna. Krishna always wants to serve Srimati Radhika, and she wants to be Didashi of Srimati Radhika. This is the highest topic of Gaudiya Vaishnava. Prabhupada and Raghunath and Gopal Bhatt took his view that Radhar Dashi, not anything else. And they want that Krishna should serve Srimati Radhika. Vishin Rash in Vrindavan, the Krishna sir, gopis are all weeping, rolling down on the earth, always searching Krishna. Oh Krishna, where you are? Without you, we will die. But Prabodhananda Saraswati has written Bhakti Radha Rasunadi. Why gopis will cry for and weep for Krishna? Krishna should be he should be
lament
that oh Srimati Radhike, where you are, I am dying for you. And searching Krishna here and there in all groves and mountains. He wants to meet Radhika and to take the feet dust off. This is the highest topic that our Goswamis has given in their books, and especially in Chaitanya Chaitanya. So all things Gopal Bhatt learned from
Prabodhananda
Saraswati. So Prabodhananda Saraswati is Guru Pad Padma of Gopal Bhatt Goswami. So you can imagine that how beautiful and how rashik and how Gopal Bhatt Goswami was. But he was a first learned also. Very, very fast. After Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came from Sri Ranga, he became mad to meet with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that you should serve your father, because he is not only your father, but he is your guru. So, you should serve him. But after that, you should come to your elder brother, Rupa and Raghunath in Vrindavan, and be with them. So, after the death
disappear.
These are parents of their father. After the death of his father, Prabodhananda Saraswati also left his home and came to Vrindavan. He lived in Kamyavan and so many, all 12 months of Vrindavan. In separation mode, oh, where is Srimati Radhika, Lalite, Vishakhe, where you are, always crying, weeping, rolling down on the earth. So Raghunath, Gopal Bhatt thought that where to leave, how to have Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet. So he also left. In the meantime, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared from this world. So he wanted to go to Puri, but he could not go to Puri. So he was searching how, where to go and how to go to in Vrindavan to in the lotus feet of the Sanatana Goswami Path and Rupa Goswami. In his tour, he went to Himalayas, where there is a Gomti Nadi, Gomti River, and he saw a big Shalagram Shila. When he was going to bathe in river, he saw that a Shalagram was coming, following him, and he is not stopping in river, and automatically it is coming, and it seems that he is telling that, I will take your service, you should serve me. Then he took up his arms and he kept it in his head, sometimes on his eyes, sometimes on his heart, and took him with him to Vrindavan, and where he met Rupa and Sanatan. Rupa Sanatan, they embraced this very pure Rashik Vaishnav Gopal Bhatt Goswami. One day he was in Vrindavan, in Radharaman Ghera. At first, no name of Radharaman Ghera. It was Vrindavan. It was in Seva Kunja, near Seva Kunja. Nidhuvan. Nidhuvan, no? In near Nidhuvan. It was in the area of Nidhuvan. Very secret and very secret place for Radha and Krishna conjugal. So he went there. And he was thinking that how I should serve her this Shalagram Shila. He went to see the eyes, face, his arms, his tree folding body, feet and everything, and he wanted to decorate it. At the time of Jhulan. Jhulan means?
Swing. First time.
In the night he slept and he was so much worried, thinking and demanding that how I can serve him. A very beautiful shape, three-folding shape, smiling face, with flow, then it will be very, very good to serve him. In the night, midnight, the Shalagram woke him. Oh, Gopal Bhatt, you can see me? How beautiful I am. And thus, he went to the deity, and saw that, oh, beautiful, Radha Raman, the face of Gopina, three-folding here, like Govind, and chest Govind, and feet were like
Mother Mama.
So then Govind, Gopinath and Mahatman appeared
three in one.
In him, three in one. In Radha. And he was so much delighted and so much glad to hear, to see this. And then he called all Goswami and they were very much surprised and wondered that how his bhakti is there. This Alagaram has changed into Radharaman. So you can imagine how first class of Vaishnava he was. Really he was not only Vaishnava. He was very near and dear to couple Radha and Krishna consumers. He was Gurumanjari of Krishna pastime. So by his prayer he became Radharaman. After that, he was not only bhauk and rasik bhakta, but he was first learned, I have told. All Vedas, all the sketches of Ramanuj, he has in his throat. Sanatana Goswami told him, asked him, that you should make some rules and regulations according to Vaishnava
etiquette.
That all can worship Radha and Krishna or anyone, and also how to take sannyas, how to take diksha, how to take mantra, what are the qualifications of disciple, what are the qualifications of guru. Everyone cannot be guru and every person cannot be disciple. Only those who are detached from worldly desires, great sense gratifications, those who have learnt all these Vedas, epics, and they have some realization of serving both Radha and Krishna, they should be guru. Whether they are of any caste and creed, but if anyone are knowing the Krishna Tattva, kiva vipra, kiva nyasi, sutra kenona, jai Krishna Tattva vetashi. Those who know Krishna, who is Krishna, who is Srimati Radhika, who am I, what is the service of Radha and Krishna conjugal, and they are loving and doing prema seva, not only virtue, they are Gurudev. Especially those is not less than 1 lakh Harinami is doing daily. And Krishna is their heart. And those who can take his Krishna also and to give in the disciple heart, he is Guru. So you can imagine this, what are the symptoms of bona fide Guru. If any person have Guru like this, he is so lucky. We are lucky that we are disciples direct from our Guruji, who was direct Shishya of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Also there are those who are the disciples of Swami Bhaktivedanta Maharaj, also they are so lucky. So to have a Guru, qualified Guru, is so bhagya, fortunate. So he wrote a book like this, and it was called Hari Bhakti Vilas. Huh? The meaning is very beautiful, meaning wonderful meaning of Hari Bhakti Vilas. Bhakti Vilas. This is one always enjoying, and he is so much in bosom Hari Bhakti Vilas. Hari Mane Krishna, who takes the heart of Srimati Radhika, he is Hari, and who is always dancing, singing in the hearts of Srimati Radhika, gopis and all, but he is Hari. And for this book was made, he wrote, and he gave it. At first, Sanatana Goswami gave him some points, and after that, he collected all the all proofs of all epics, and he gave in all Puran, especially all Purans and Nigam and Agam, and collected so many things, months, and gave it. And again, Srila Sanatan Goswami gave him first him all these things, and again he explained, he wrote
commentaries
on Hari Bhakti Vilas. So someone are in Sunday
doubt
that this book is of Sanatan Goswami really or of
Gopal Bhatta Goswami.
But I think the book was manifested by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in their hearts, and he gave inspiration to make it. So he wrote. Also, he wrote Hari Bhakti Vilas, Satriya
Sardipika, Sanskar Dipika,
and Sarsangar. Three books.
And condensed form of Sarsangar.
So we should try to follow how to make temples, how to give diksha, how to give mantra. We don't call first initiation, second initiation, third initiation, fourth initiation. Only one initiation. First in Harinam and then Diksha. Not Swamiji had made easy grammar because he was so kripalu, merciful. So he made some easy grammars for this. So he called first Diksha means to take Harinam. And then to clear and to make it bona fide Harinam, Diksha is essential. Someone thinks that Diksha is more superior. But you can know that Mantri is Shrestman,
superior.
Our name is superior. What is superior? Vijayate Sri Krishna.
Param
Vijayate Sri Krishna. Name is himself Krishna. By mantra, detachedness comes. Detachment from world, no attachment from world, cuts this mantra and gives some relation to Krishna. So Gurudev gives him Harinam and then Diksha Guru, or in Diksha, how to chant Krishna name with relation of Krishna or relation with Srimati Radhika. And then this name becomes so pure and becomes conjugal Radha and Krishna. So, all things has been given in Hari Bhakti Vilas he gave. Some he gave in Satriya Sardipika. Anyone who is taking shelter of Radha Krishna and pure Vaishnava, they should not worship demigods. They should worship Rup Sanatan, Yamuna, Govardhan, Radha Kund, Shyam Kund, Vrinda Devi, they should worship. Lalita, Vishakha, not other thing, not Rukmini Raman, Satyabhama Raman, Mathuresh Krishna. If they are doing so, then they cannot come in Vrindavan. So he has told everything, how to do all these things. If marriage ceremony should be done according to Kshatriya Sardipika, not worshipping Ganesh and all other deities. If a Vaishnava who has taken sannyas, renounce order, when he departs from this world, he should give him samadhi, how samadhi should be given. Everything. There are so many sanskar.
Ten
sanskar also have been cleared there. So we are very fortunate to come in his line, and also be indebted to Sanatan Goswami, Rup Goswami, and this Srila Gopal Bhatta. Today is also the
disappearance
day of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. You know all Raghunath Goswami. If anyone wants to be in Gaudiya Vaishnava, if anyone wants to dive in the ocean of a rush, brought by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navadvip or here, they should surely follow Rupa Raghunath Pade Raghu Mura Ash Prarthana Kare Sada Naru. If anyone has no tendency, if then anyone has no ruchi,
taste,
to serve Radha Krishna conjugal in this way like Rupa and Raghunath, they should surely go to Mayabad join. And they should go to Ramanuj. They should not be in Gaudiya Sampradaya. Surely they will have it. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or any of his followers and all disciples, they have not come only to give Vaidhi Bhakti only. If you read Chaitanya Charitamrita, if you read the explanations of Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur Ji Goswami and Sanatana Goswami Gopal Bhatti, you will see even Narottam Thakur Srinivasa Acharya and
Shyamananda
Prabhu, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, all will tell the essence of all Vaishnavism, essence of all the books, essence of all the teachings. To serve Radha Krishna in line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If I am telling that we are not qualified to learn and hear and to do, then that should be very far away from our lives. Very, very far away. That should not join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Bhakti Vaidhan Swami Maharaj's mission, Srila Prabhupada's mission and our mission. So ultimate goal to serve Radha and Krishna conjugal Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anarpati Charin Chirat Karanaya Avatir. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami had told, Rupa Goswami had told, Raghunath especially has told, Tabai Vasmi, Tabai Vasmi, Najima Mitvaya Vina, Iti Vijnaya Radhe, Tamnaya Mama Charanam. Oh, Srimati Radha, I am yours, yours, I am yours. If you have no mercy, if you not bestow mercy to me, then I will die, I will die. I will leave Vrindavan, I will leave Krishna, I will leave everything, I will leave my body, if your mercy is not coming to me. I don't know Krishna, I don't want to serve Krishna. Without you, Padabjayostava vina varadasyameva nannat kadapi samaye tiladevija sakhyayate mamo namastu namastu nityam dasyayate mamo rasostu rasostu. Very good. What we cannot understand in the books of Rupa Goswami, we can understand easily by the books of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. Srila Rupa Goswami has brought the ocean of Rasa, Bhakti Rasamit Sindhu. He has brought, you know, all. But how to dive, how to take some water, and how to bath in that Rasa Sindhu, the path has made Srila Raghunath. Without following him, we cannot go to that ocean of bhakti, Bhakti Rasamrita. So we'll have to follow, especially Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in Padvi and Raghunath Das Goswami met him in Shantipur, you know Raghunath Das Goswami, he was the prince. He was very, very high class of rich person's son. There were two brothers, his fathers. The whole property was of Raghunath Das Goswami. When their father and mother saw that he has some inclination
for Radha and Krishna to serve and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They wanted to turn his boat, but they could not. Raghunath Das Goswami has tried so many times to give up his home and to go to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Puri. At last, big and very
strong watchman.
The strong iron or
chain
were brought to Titan Raghunath Das Goswami. So many watchkeepers were there to always look after him that he should not fly away from home. At last, his mother told his father, his husband, you should try to tight him and always guard. Then he thought, in this world, iron chains and all these things are not so strong, like wipes for attraction. So he looked after whole Bengal, very beautiful Kishori for him. And he was married. He was unwilling to marry, but anyhow they forcefully. They married that beautiful princess, was brought to Raj Palace, but he had nothing to do. He had never seen his wife. What is called wife, he did not know what is wife. Then again she told her mother that how to tighten her. Only my son is there in our family, and if he becomes sadhu, then what to do? How we will say we will die? You should try to tighten him in iron bars. Then his father, Hiranya Govardhan, told that a love affection of father and mother and charmingness of his wife, everything we are tried by all these things. So if anyone's heart is taken by Krishna, they cannot be tightened by anything
material,
whether it will the wife be so beautiful, loving, serving, anyhow so sweet, fragrant, and everything, but they have no use of that, they cannot tighten. So how this
lifeless iron
bolts, how come they can bind it? Raghunath